I've an awful feeling about this. You'll be hurt out there. I couldn't handle that.
I'll be careful, I promise. And when I'm flush with coin and set up, I'll send for you. I will.
Caroline, come away! Don't exert yourself!
I can't promise I'll come, Edward. If you leave on this fool's errand, I cannot promise anything.
Don't give up on me, Caroline! Not when I need your faith the most.
Putting some shape to your sentiments?
Just a short letter home. I reckon she's past caring anyway.
Oh, you're a hard heart that should be softer.
Or soft in parts that should be hard.
And how is it you're so keen for his hard parts, Mr. Rackham?
You'd like to know my secrets, would you?
Oh, aye. Give me a small hint, like. Or a large one, if you're an upright gentleman.
Open your hand.
Oh!
Who's shooting?
Might be them ships sliding into port.
Jesus.
Loaded upon a bargain, I'll warrant.
I'll be hanged. King George has grown tired of our shenanigans.
Who's the grim fella?
That's Captain Woods Rogers. Not a man I want seeing my face.
We desire a parley with the men who call themselves governors of this island.
Charles Vane, Ben Hornigold, and Ed Thatch. Come forth, if you please.
Hear about the king's pardon, I reckon.
What the hell is Hornigold doing?
Lily-livered punk!
What are you men up to?
I am grateful for your geniality, Captain Hornigold. I assumed our reception would be a troubled one.
Don't mistake my decorum for deference, Governor. I'm eager to hear what you have to say, but of uncertain mind otherwise.
Very well put.
Only wait a while longer, Governor Rogers. These rascals will show their true colors in time.
Calm, Commodore Chamberlain. I have given Captain Hornigold my word that we will be able to...
Won't do you a lick of good. Men like him are a blight on His Majesty's reputation and a peculiar cancer afflicting the New World. The King wants them eradicated, above all else.
Is this the town square?
As close to one as we've ever had.
Incredible. It's no cleaner than a dog's kennel.
Captain Hornigold, please call your men.
Rackham, Vane, the governor's come calling. Bring Burgess and Corcoran as well.
A lot of you. Make way for the King's emissaries.
Out of the way,
bastards. Go on. Our only aim here is to treat with the masters of this community. All others are encouraged to go about their usual business.
Go on, move! Go!
Commodore Chamberlain, please see that all merchants, masons, and carpenters are rounded up and brought to me this afternoon. We must see about repairing this fortress.
We should be confiscating weapons, Governor. Send these pirates a clear, strong message that the King's emissaries are not to be trifled with.
I have no wish to stir up animosity, Commodore. So well armed, we are outnumbered by a decent margin. Slow persuasion is our most efficient weapon.
Waddle, Governor. We should think every goddamn ship not flying the King's colors. To do otherwise, we should express weakness in our bearings.
Commodore, I am a goddamn governor here, serving at the King's pleasure, and I will make the bloody decision. Is that clear, sir?
Sharks, Commodore. We're in position.
Governor Rogers believes he can make men of these monkeys yet. I do not. Return to your post and await my orders.
eyes, you... Don't let you get away!
We do hereby promise and declare that in case any of the said pirates shall on or before the 5th of September, in the year of our Lord 1718, surrender him or themselves to any one of the principal secretaries of state in Great Britain or Ireland, or to any governor or deputy governor of any of our provinces, every such pirate and pirate shall surrender in him or themselves, and for death shall have our gracious pardon of and for such his or their piracy or pirates by him or them committed before the 5th of January next ensuing, and we do hereby strictly charge and command all our admiral, captain, and other officers at sea, and all our governors and commanders of any forts, castles, or other places in our plantations, and all our officers, civil and military, to seize and take such of the pirates who shall refuse or neglect to surrender themselves accordingly.
You!
I pray you take the prudent course, gentlemen, and accept the king's pardon as soon as your hearts allow. For until such time, all of you will be confined in Nassau.
I am sorry for this.
But in lieu of a public trial, this pardon is your best bet.
The governor puts it far too brightly, maggots. Take this message home. Accept the king's protection forthwith, or we will raise this town to its foundation and stretch your bloody necks.
Peace, Commodore Chamberlain. We are messengers, not executioners. Not yet.
Oh, thank you, sir. God save you.
Look on this as a stroke of fortune, lads. We should take the king's pardon and salvage what dignity we own.
Peace. I'll be hanged before I surrender to that bobby.
Check your head, Vane. We had here a rare opportunity, a chance to take something base and shape it into a government made and maintained by men of vision. But in 2 years, we pissed it away. I won't make that mistake again.
Its truth is telling, and you whelps can't handle it.
A Jew, you forecastle-headed fuddlers. See you at the gallows.
You'll all be dead, men! Bastards!
I need a drink. Look at him. Turncoat. Makes me bloody ill to think on how many times I've put up with Hornigold and his self-righteous shite.
Verily, you are a man of principle, Captain Hornigold. A man I believe I can trust with my best ideas.
Faith, and we'll survive this, Charles, with our pride intact.
Well, that's confidence. You brewed a plan I might get a taste of?
Nassau is over, that's plain to see. I say we skip out tonight and regroup at my compound.
Fair enough. What's your angle?
The Brits have brought their supplies ashore, see? If we nick some gunpowder and pine pitch, we can build a fire ship and send it straight at the blockade, blasting it to smithereens.
Aye. We'll use Rackham's ship. Ain't a capable captain.
My conscience is clear.
Right. When you get the gunpowder, I'll secure the pine pitch.
Well?
No!
You won't lose that sadly, Billy. You're mine!
I'll blow him to pieces!
Stay right. He thinks he can get away. Interloper, raise the alarm. That easily. You come back here. Yes.
Yes, you!
Now, now, no need to get your drunken ass.
You! Stop!
Prepare to bleed!
Stand still.
Hey, you're in the shrub. Out!
Never been away from a place like that.
Day. I hope I see you well.
Come on, boys, you're lagging.
It's this bloody amp.
Lieutenant!
Aye, sir.
The Commodore fears a revolt is nigh. His orders are to sink every goddamn pirate ship now anchored in that harbor, tonight.
It's by the Governor's wishes, sir.
This is a direct order, soldier. You will take position on the grounded galleon and await the Commodore's further orders. Is that clear?
Aye, sir!
The conniving bastard. Someone ought to slit the Commodore's throat before he gets a chance to bark those orders.
You think so?
We're dead in the water otherwise.
All right, I'll kill him.
Your brains are baked. I won't take no part in killing the Commodore. Not one of the King's men.
But we can't risk our good fortune. be waiting for you.
Rogers and Chamberlain. What's the issue?
The Commodore don't think much of civilians, I reckon. And there's a rumor going around that Rogers is some kind of Jacobite, or worse, that he's a Catholic.
Oh, I could think of worse.
Gather those two men there.
Sense of humor.
Come on there, man! Come on, boy!
Governor's given us a pardon, Commodore. Don't a man's word mean anything in these times?
Has syphilis clouded your mind? Why scratch and claw to protect such squalor? Your parasites feeding off the industry of honest men.
Much like King George in that respect.
Know your place, peasant! You may have taken my life, but you have not improved your own by any measure.
Does some purpose keep you talking?
If not for that heathen, Governor Rogers, I'd have seen you hanged from your own cross trees. Worm. All of you.
Commodore's dead. Are we ready?
We're close. We've got a problem with the galleon. There's a couple of dozen. Bloody hell!
You'd raise a cloud here, lout! You sat on enough gunpowder to blow New Providence off its rocks!
Lay off me, mate. I'm well chafed.
As I was telling, a squad of lobsters has commandeered our galleon. We're gonna have to clear it out before we use them cannons to blow the blockade.
Stay near the fireship, Captain. Keep it afloat.
Loose all and trim sharp to the wind! Close up! Ease her sticks!
Four! Haul up all but mains!
Crowd it all on!
Loose all!
The Brits are on to us. Look there!
But where are you, squad?
Ready to spit, sir!
Fire!
Reload! Won't miss next time.
We're ready, sir!
Fire!
The sword explodes! Fire! Take the shot, sir!
Crowd on every inch of sail!
Stunsels out!
Fire! Ghost the gallant
that is weak!
Damn these eyes!
Here's on the wind! More sail! All sail! Haul in the stunsail!
Get those clues up!
Kilavern, sir!
Sir, there's loot floating here!
Hold sail! She'll take it!
Blow the dogs out!
There'll be more of the dogs, sir!
Fire!
Look out, the whole place shot there!
Fire!
They're so exposed, take the shot, sir!
Fire!
Give the order, sir!
Mighty mess there.
Burn your bastards! Yeah! The burning up your ass, Governor!
Prancing about like they took a prize.
Kid. You missed quite a time.
Aye. Pity about Nassau and Blackbeard flying the coop.
Well, we'll see about Thatch.
Vane's off to see him now, and I'm following soon.
This is what's left of your experiment in democracy.
Aye. We do as we please here, and we take our time doing it.
But for Christ's sake, Edward, don't anything but the stink of riches wrinkle your nose.
What's got into you, man?
Reality, mate. Reality. See that you ain't pulled into the drink by this drowning rat.
Oi. I've lived longer than most men who trod this path.